you yet living?
Is it possible to stay to God? Yes, I meet you, as Signor Bethlehem. Courtesy itself has converted to stain if you come in for
presence. Then is courtesy a turncoat. But it is certain I am loved of all ladies. Only you excepted. And I would I could find in my heart that I had not a hard heart, for truly, I love you.
A dear courtesy to women. May else you have been troubled with a pernicious suitor. I gotta hear my dog bark at a throat than a man's lady
love. God keep your ladyship still in that mind, so some gentleman or other may scape the predestined scratched face.
Scratching could not make it worse, and for such a face as yours.
Well, you're a rare parrot, teacher.
Of course, my tongue is better than a beast of yours.
I would my horse had the speed of your tongue. You always end with a jade's trick. That a woman conceived me, I thank her. That she brought me up, I likewise give her most humble thanks. But that I will
He's the prince's jester.
That I will have
a very dull fool. His only gift is in devising impossible slanders. None but libertines the like.
She misused me past the endurance of a block. She called me the prince's jester. Muttering jest upon jest with such impossible conveyance upon me that I stood like a man at a mark with an entire army shooting at me. She speaks poniards, and every word stabs. I did not marry her, though she were endowed with everything Adam had left him before he transgressed. Certainly, while she is here, a man may live as quiet in hell as in a sanctuary, and people sin on purpose, because they would go thither. So indeed, all horror, perturbation, and disquiet follows her. The prince and Monsieur Love. I will hide myself in the arbor.
See, so you have met the captain himself.
Oh, very well, my lord.
Come hither, Leonardo. What was it that you told me of earlier today? That your niece Beatrice was in love with Signor Benedict?
Aye, I did.
Never think that lady would have loved any man.
No, nor I neither. But it does please me that she should so dote on Signor Benedict, whose cap, in all outward behaviors, seemed ever to abhor.
Is it possible, since the wind in that corridor?
By my troth, my lord, I cannot tell what to think of it, but that she loves him with an enraged affection. This past the infinite of thought.
Maybe she loves but a counterfeit.
Say, like enough.
There was never any counterfeit of passion. It came so near the light of passion that she discovered it.
I would have my brother's spirit have been invincible against all self-affection.
I would have sworn it had, my lord. Especially against Benedict.
I should think this a goal, but that the fellow speaks it. Knavery cannot sure hide itself in such reverence.
He has taken the infection and pulled it off.
Perhaps she made her affection known to Benedict.
No. And she swears she never will. That's her torment.
She got well. If she should make tender of her love, 'tis very possible to scorn it. For the man, as you know all, hath a contemptible spirit.
Shall we go seek Benedict and tell him of her love?
Never tell him, my lord. Well, we will hear further of it by your daughter. Let it cool a while.
I love Benedict well, and I could wish he would modestly examine himself to see how much he is unworthy so good a lady. Let us send her to call him into dinner.
Love me? Why, it must be requited. They say the lady is fair. 'Tis the truth. I can bear them witness. But virtuous, 'tis so. I cannot reprove it. Wise, but for loving me, for I will be horribly in love with her. Here comes Beatrice. By this day, she is a fair lady. I do spy some marks of love in her.
Against my will, I insist that you come to dinner.
Fair Beatrice, I thank you for your pains.
If it had been paid for, I would not have come.
You take pleasure then in the message.
Yes, Signor, just so much as you may.
Against my will, I am sent bid you come into dinner.
There's a double meaning to that.
Let it be thy heart to praise him more than ever, man of merit. For our talk must be... Benedict is sick in love with Beatrice. Indeed, Ursula. She is too disdainful. I know her spirits are as coy and wild as haggards of rock.
Are you sure that Benedict loves Beatrice?
So entirely? So says the prince in my Lord.
And did they bid you tell her of it, madam?
They did entreat me to acquaint her of it, but I persuaded them, if they loved Benedict, to wish him wrestled with affection.
And never to let Beatrice know of it.
Why did you so? She cannot love, nor take no shame nor reject of affection.
She is so self-endeared.
Sure, I think so. And therefore it were best she knew not of his love, lest she make sport of it.
But who dare tell her so? If I should speak, she would mock me into the air, or she would laugh at me.
Yet tell her of it. See what she will say.
No.
Rather,
I will go to Benedict and counsel him fight against his passion.
Do not anger me, madam, speaking my fancy. Señor Benedict, you were shaped for bearing arguments and valor goes in high report throughout all of Italy.
Indeed, he hath an excellent good name.
His excellence did earn it ere he had it.
When are you married? Why, every day tomorrow. Come, go in. We have talked to the matter. If it proves so, then loving goes by halves. Some cupids kill with arrows, some with traps.
What fire is in my ears? Can this be true? And Benedict, love on, I will requite thee, taking my wild heart to thy loving hand.
Sweet Beatrice, wouldst thou come when I call thee?
Yea, senor, I will depart when you bid me.
Stay till then.
Benedict has spoken. Very well.
I pray thee, tell me, for which of my bad parts did you first fall in love with me?
For them altogether. Which maintain so politic a state of evil that nothing could intermingle with them. But tell me, for which of my good parts did you first suffer love from me?
Suffer love? A good epithet, I do suffer love indeed, for I love thee against my will.
In spite of your heart, I say alas, poor heart, if you spite it for my sake, I will spite it for yours.
Thou and I are too wise to rule peaceably. Do not you love me?
Why, no. No more than reason.
Then your uncle and the prince and Claudio were deceived, for they swore you did.
Do you not love me?
No more than reason.
Why then, Hero and Ursula were much deceived, for they did swear you did.
They said you were almost sick for me.
They said you were well nigh dead for me.
Tis no such matter. Then you do not love me.
No, truly. But in friendly welcome.
I can love nothing in the world so well as you. Is not that strange?
A strange thing, I know not. Were it possible for me to say I love nothing so well as I do. But believe me not, yet I find it. But I confess nothing, nor do I...
By my sword, Beatrice, thou lovest me.
Do not swear me.
I will swear by it that you love me, and I will make him eat it that saith I love not you.
Will you not eat your word?
No sauce that could be devised to it. I protest, I love thee.
Why then, God forgive me!
What offense, sweet Beatrice?
You have saved me a happy hour. I was about to protest I love you.
Do it. With all my heart!
I love you with so much of my heart that there is not much to protest. Yet, I yield upon great persuasion, and partly to save your body, for I was told you were the presumption.